sounds fantastic. You must be very proud.
These things are not possible without the extraordinary performers you can work with. This is what gives you obviously the pleasure and the, as you say, pride in it. But it's there. They're the proud ones.
But I mean, the coming together of all of these cultures is a brilliant time, very timely this year.
Well, it is something we've been doing for quite a while. It really is the ethos of the Grand Union Orchestra, which is basically a professional group of musicians, which I set up quite a long time ago, who come from mostly living in London, though not necessarily, but who have their origins, were born and bred into different musical cultures from Africa, the Caribbean, China, Bangladesh, South America, wherever, and singers as well. So I love the music of various musical cultures. I learn it through the musicians themselves. So everything I learn about Indian music, it's been working with Indian musicians, for example, but also the singers, because people who sing in different languages, like Chinese or Bengali or Portuguese, or there's something about how they sing which expresses their background or their emotions or where they come from. So this show is really the quintessence of that. So we're telling the stories of the people, and why it's so moving is that you could actually believe that the people you're hearing singing, they're telling of their life is unfolding in front of you, if you see what I mean. And it has an authenticity about the music. So, but this is the great thing about living. I mean, we're a national organisation and do these projects abroad as well. But East London is very special. It's where I've always lived and always worked.
It's so multicultural, isn't it, East London?
That's right. And I think the important thing is to, in current political situation, social position in particular, we need things that take a positive view, that balance out the kind of, at the worst, at the least, the doominess, but sometimes the sheer hostility or animosity that is expressed towards people from, simply from somewhere else, really, newcomers.
And music has the power to do that. That's why it's such
absolutely,
a spectacular
that's
thing.
Right.
It brings people together. You don't need one language. It's multilingual, isn't it, music?
It is, and you can hear from even that piece that it's the rhythms, West African rhythm, for example. We can call on Afro-Cuban rhythms, Caribbean rhythms, Indian Bhangra beats as a way of expressing things. And it occurred to me the other day, I think, why the music is so strong and immediate is that it's based in rhythm, so people respond to that. That's not particularly usual, I think, in popular music. Obviously, there is rhythm, but it's relatively conventional. And in classical music, there is no rhythm in the sense that you have a. And I think that's what kind of draws people in to what you're doing.
And you said you've been doing it for a while. So how long has this been going on for?
About 30 years,
oh,
really.
Wow.
I know it's a long time. It started because I was writing theatre music. There was a time when I was the sort of go-to person in all over the country for writing music for shows, and so that's partly why they're sort of dramatic. But I wanted to do a piece about migration and exile, so I couldn't do that without having people. This is authenticity that I'm talking about, having people who had experienced that as economic migrants or refugees or asylum seekers. And then, of course, they bring their music with them. So we had a Chilean who had been in prison under Pinochet and then played all the classic Chilean instruments. And that was, that was again, the authenticity that you could feel the that sort of resistance, like Victor Jara. And so it's building all that in. The chance which set us off was that the GLC had won it years against things, and one of the last one, I think, probably under Livingstone, was a year against racism. And so we were then commissioned, because we did what we do, to put a piece together that expressed that.
Okay. Well, it sounds absolutely fantastic. And what a year, because these are the topics that are in the headlines at the moment. It's what everybody's talking about.
You're right, but that's interesting, because of course we set this in motion quite a long time ago, knowing about the Windrush.
Windrush special, isn't it?
That's right. Although it's it also stands for all the other migrants, so it's a kind of, it's an emblem, if you like. But what we didn't know is, of course, that it would blow up into this kind of scandal.
Oh, so absolutely.
And at the same time, you can express something about the way that we regard other migrants besides the Windrush generation.
Tony Haynes, we'll leave it there, but thank you very much indeed for all of that.